Here we are at the 1986 Hillstrock. This film is a depiction. None of the characters are real. There's one of the musicians. People playing frisbee on the lawn. The cars are coming in.
I'm supposed to introduce a musical act and do some jokes or whatever to keep you guys amused in between changes. I think you'll like a lot of the jokes. I used a lot of them at my uncle's funeral this summer. They went over really well. But mostly I'll just be doing my usual, the nervous guy. So it's kind of an ongoing impression that I do. The music should be very good, and it'll be probably amusing to watch me try to keep my head above water for the next 4 hours or so. So here we go. This is Hillstrock. Billed as a unique blend of folk, rock, jazz, classical music, I guess they mean. I'm sure you'll go home tonight with many wonderful memories and fine stories to tell. Admission is free, as you mentioned. But you're encouraged to make a free will or even a guilt motivated offer. Supposedly you just go to the Student Housing Fund with the motto, get students off campus and into houses. Okay, I'll tell that one too. It's to go to pay for cutting down all the trees on campus during Environment Awareness Week. It's to show our solidarity with the McDonald's Corporation. We cut down all the rainforest in Latin America and to put up beef ranches. And so to show our solidarity, we're going to take out all these big trees and mail them to the White House. Okay, so this is Hillstrock. And it's going to be like Woodstock. That's Woodstock. That's a really small, sleepy town of 40 miles outside Toronto. So maybe that's a little more low key than the big rock festival. Oh yeah, just something to keep in mind during the next few hours. It was 15 years ago this month that the Partridge Family began their.
Yeah!
All right! Woo!
I know that it's one of my first introductions to serious music. I hope that you feel the same way I do. Okay, now for our first performer is Charlie Crook. He's going to play. He's going to play folk guitar. He's billed as the author of The Gambler. So I don't know, it's maybe like a children's story or I don't know what. Anyway, for now, now for someone who really knows what was over in this town, Charlie Crook. I gotta really get close to this mic so I don't have a lot
of December was covered with snow. So was the turnpike from Stockbridge to Boston. The Berkshires seemed dreamlike on account of the frosting. With 10 miles behind me and 10,000 more to go. There's a song that they sing when they take to the highway, a song that they sing when they take to the sea, a song that they sing of their home in the sky. Maybe you can believe it if it helps you to sleep. But singing works just fine for me. Good night, you moonlight ladies. Rock-a-bye, sweet baby James. Deep greens and blues are the colors I choose. Won't you let me go down in my dreams and rock-a-bye, sweet baby James.
Now comes the fun stuff. This song, which Jay Mills referred to, is called The Preacher. On a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for Newton, I met up with a preacher. We were both too tired to sleep. He had his Bible open to the book of Leviticus. The boredom overtook him, and he began to speak. But he said, son, I've made a life out of reading people's faces and knowing how my sermon went by the way they held their eyes. Now, if you don't mind my saying, well, I've preached a lot of places. If you've got a minute, I'll give you some advice. So I moved up closer near him, so I could clearly hear him. Then he put his glasses on to help improve his sight. And the night was deathly quiet, but his face, it gained expression. Said, if you've got a congregation, boy, you gotta learn to treat them right. Well, you got to know when to hold them. Know when to scold them, know when to make them laugh, and know when it's dumb. Well, you never count your converts while you're standing in the pulpit. There'll be time enough for counting when the preaching's done. Every preacher knows that the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away and knowing what to keep. Cause sermons can be losers, and sermons can be winners. The best that you can hope for is that no one falls asleep. Well, when he finished preaching, he turned back toward the window, closed up his Bible, and faded off to sleep. And somewhere in the darkness, the preacher met his teacher. But in his final words I found a message that I could keep. Well, you got to know when to hold them, know when to scold them, know when to make them laugh, and know when it's dumb. Well, you never count your converts while you're standing in the pulpit. There'll be time enough for counting when the preaching's done. My final song is one that some of you may have heard from the late Harry Chapin, the Circle Song.
All my life's a circle, sunrise and sundown. Moon rolls through the night time till the daybreak comes around. All my life's a circle, and I can't tell you why. The season's spinning round again, the years keep rolling by. Seems like I've been here before, I can't remember when. But I've got this funny feeling that I'll be back again. There's no straight lines make up my life, and all my roads have bends. There's no clear-cut beginnings, Boston, so far no dead ends.
Ah, hornet over here. I've found you a thousand times, I guess you've done the same. But when we lose each other, it's just a children's game. But as I see you here again, the thought runs through my mind. Our love is like a circle, let's go round one more time. All my life's a circle, sunrise and sundown. The moon rolls through the nighttime till the daybreak comes around. All my life's a circle, and I can't tell you why. The season's spinning round again, the years keep rolling by.
Going well, everyone having a great time. It's good to see everyone. It's good to see everyone out there boogieing. What does boogieing mean anyway? So much did you pay? $0 and cents. So you're really getting your maximum enjoyment out of this for the money. That's good. It's good.
Okay.
Maximum enjoyment from your investment in Nanorenewable Future. Should we wait for a children's portion till later? Okay. Well, no, I mean, is that okay? Well, okay. I'd like to just issue a little complaint at this point. You know the big new Andover Newton catalog, big thing? Looks really good. The catalog, all the courses and everything, really nicely done. But there's nothing in it about the PhD program that I'm in and some of the people here in. And I think they should have. Now, I sent in some pictures of myself that I thought would have been suitable. You know, I didn't hear anything in the back. I could have written something nice. What? Someone must have tampered with the mail system. You know, the mail routine. But anyway, and I'm sure I could have written up something really nice, like Bob Azzini's thing, expanding the circle, like closing the mind or something. I don't know. But they didn't let me do it. But anyway, our next, this brings us to our next performer. Dawn Larson will do some comedy and folk. Now, last week, I wrote a song for her. I don't know if she's going to perform it, so it'll be a surprise to me as much to you. Called Newton Skyline. Kind of a sentimental number, but I kind of liked it, and I thought if she wanted to sing it, it'd go right ahead. It'd be a good first run for it, but I don't know if she'll do it or not. But anyway, we'll bring out, without further ado, Dawn Larson.
One of the things that I appreciate at these kind of things is where people sing along. Ha, that's you. So, we're going to do a little warm-up. Your part is moo. Okay, let's hear some moos from the audience. One, two, three.
Moo.
Very good. And you do that after each line. We sold our cows.
Moo.
don't need. For your bowl now, for your bowl now. Alright, you did such a great job. I'm going to let you sing along with the chorus of this song. It's called Old Time Religion. And my paper.
Good enough for me. Oh, give me that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. And that's good enough for me.
We will play with Zarathustra. We'll play just like we used to. I'm a Zarathustra booster. And that's good enough for me. Oh, give me that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. And that's good enough for me. We will pray with those Egyptians. Build pyramids to put our crypts in. Cover subways with inscriptions. And that's good enough for me. Oh, give me that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. And that's good enough for me. We will pray with those old druids. They drink fermented fluids, waltzing naked through the woods. And that's good enough for me. Oh, give me that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. And that's good enough for me. Hare Krishna, he must laugh on to see me dressed in saffron with my hair that's only half on. And that's good enough for me. Oh, give me that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. Give me that old time religion. And that's good enough for me. I will rise at early morning when my Lord gives me the warning that the solar age is dawning. For me, oh, give me that old time religion, give me that old time religion, give me that old time religion, and that's good enough for me. This is your last chance. Give me that old time religion, give me that old time religion, give me that old time religion, and that's good enough for me. Pretty sneaky way to get applause, huh? Get people to clap along with you. Okay. Thank you for the clip, Matt McCaffrey. Otherwise, I would be stuck somewhere. Okay. This song is about... Oh, it's important that we have a cable, otherwise I can't sing. So, this song is about what happens after we die, or when we die. It's written by, I think it's written by John Denver. I got it from John Denver. Oh, lay me down in forest lawn in a silver casket. Put golden flowers over my head with a silver basket. Let the drum and bugle corps play taps while cannons roar. Let 16 liveried employees sell souvenirs at the funeral store. I want to go simply when I go. They'll give me a simple funeral there, I know. With a casket lined in fleece and fireworks spelling out rest in peace. Oh, take me when I'm gone, forest lawn. Oh, lay me down in forest lawn, they understand there. They have a heavenly choir and a military band there. Just put me in their care, I'll find my comfort there. With 16 planes and a lap salute, they'll drop across in a parachute. I want to go simply when I go. They'll give me a simple funeral there, I know. With 100 strolling strings and topless dancers with golden wings. Oh, take me when I'm gone, forest lawn. Come, 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 come to the church in the wild. Contribution in the pail. Be as simple and as trusting as a child would, and we'll sell you the church in the pail to find it. a simple resting place is my desire. To lay me down with a smiling face comes a little bit higher. My likeness cast in brass will stand in frosty grass while a kitten waits and springs tippets hats to the mourner's filing pass. I want to go simply when I go. They'll give me a simple funeral there, I know. I'll lie beneath the sand with piped intakes of Billy Graham. Oh, take me when I'm gone, for it's long. Rock of ages clapped for me, for a slightly higher fee. Oh, take me when I'm gone, for it's long. One of the things that you might see posters up about on campus is that the Women's Resource Center is having a clothing drive, so if you feel like cleaning out your campus, or your closet, clean out your campus, and giving some of those clothes that keep people warm to, another one, gosh. Okay. To people who will be cold, this is a good way to drop your clothes off in Sturtevant, and this song gives you the solution of how you can keep warm this winter. This is written by Fred Small, who's somebody who I saw playing at a coffee house at JP Junction. Just last night, in fact. It's called A Modest Proposal. I remember well when I was but a child of tender years, the day that I discovered the catalog from Sears. The people in the pictures, they made me stop and stare. Who'd have guessed that they'd be dressed in thermal underwear? Underwear, long underwear. It makes the foulest weather feel like fair. It's 10 below and icy winds go whistling through the air. Let it store my toasty warm inside my underwear. Prudence says to set a thermostat at 65. In skimpy briefs and brassieres, you will not survive. The Lord in all her wisdom gave us more than skin and hair. She gave us wit ourselves to fit in thermal underwear. Underwear, long underwear. Underneath our clothes, without it, we are bare. Plutonium is perilous and coal pollutes the air. The energy source at best, of course, is thermal underwear. Paul Newman wears it all the time, and Redford, he does too. Bode Eric swears that it's the only thing to do. Lovers, if you think that taking off your clothes is nice, do not miss the greater bliss of taking them off twice. Underwear, long underwear. Slip inside and leave behind your cares. The oil and gas kingdoms will rant and tear their hair. Who needs them? We've got a friend in thermal underwear. Who needs them? We've got a friend in thermal underwear. The problem with clits is you have to put them all back on when you change the paper.
For the trustees.
I just learned last year as I came to seminary from a tape that Deb Moore gave me. So this is for her. It's a song written by Betsy Rose, or at least performed by her. And it's called In the Very Front Row. And you have to listen to the words, especially any of you who are in seminary. Oh, her father is a graduate from here. Courtesy of Robin Joyce. Okay. The song is called In the Very Front Row, and just imagine yourself when you were a kid going to school. On Sunday morning we drove to church, Daddy looking stiff in his long black robe. And I wore a pink starch dress with blue jean shorts underneath. Mama didn't know that. We promised that we would all behave, and we
the very front row. The program became a paper airplane. Somehow a hymnal fell to the floor. My sisters giggled and I said the Lord's Prayer very loud. Mama didn't like that, and more often than not when Daddy preached, Mom would escort the five of us all outside. I tried to be good, I tried to be holy, tried to shake hands in a grown-up way. But one time we played strip poker out on the church lawn. Daddy didn't like that, for how would it look to those Baptists down the street? They already thought we were down. There was old Beacon Bisbee's pockets full of blackjack gum that he gave to me. And Mrs. Perkins poured coffee into my cup of cream. Mama didn't know that. And running between those grown-up legs, I felt for a moment I was safe. And yesterday I went to church to be with my friend in her long black robe. And I didn't giggle or drop the hymnal or make paper airplanes. I was a good girl, and she couldn't look at me without smiling as I sat in the very front row.
Testing. Three. That's how you count in Canada. Three. It's kind of click language we use up there. Like that movie, that God's Must Be Crazy. Canada, it's real. That's how you pronounce it. This, we could be running into our first major snag here. Is Dan Davis out there? Our next performer? Okay, because we didn't have room for anyone. Well, then we'll have to, that'll be Mark New and Liz.
Woo!
But just we don't remember that, you know, the children's portion has to be first. You guys just know if you're good. Because this brings us to the children's portion of our show. It's kind of like the church, you know, you tell a children's story. Now, for those of you who are ministers out there, I'd like to make a recommendation. Because this has worked for me when I've done sermons or worship services, is you have an adult story, and you have the adults all come to the front and sit around you on the steps, and you tell them a story, and you're really directing your remarks to the children in the pews over their heads. Like, you know, you get the adults to say something like, so what do you think of Skeletor? And the adults won't know, and the kids will all laugh because they'll know who that is. And it's kind of cute to see the adults, you know, their crazy answers and stuff. So you might try that the next time you're around. Now, Phil asked me to maybe give advice to some of the kids that come out of teenagers and someone like that. And my advice to them is don't grow up too fast. And now what I had in mind really was things like, you know, when you're a kid, you can you don't have to buy a card, you know, when you get a gift or something, you can make a card. And that can save you a lot of money. So put off the time where you think that you're too old to make a card and, you know, attach it to a gift to give someone, because you could save, you know, $1.75. $1.75 a card, you know, in a whole lifetime that can add up. Because as you get older, you can do more like joke cards. And that can save you money. For instance, what I do, I get postcards for my hometown, small town, you know, so you could go down to your local store and get local postcards. And you just tape it to like an index card like this. And so it'll open up. And then you can put, you know, like happy birthday or happy Mother's Day, whatever, on the inside. And you've got the index card right there. And it's kind of like a joke. You know, people won't really mind that you've spent 15 cents rather than, you know, $1.75. The other thing is about wrapping things. You can save on wrapping paper by using like newspaper, magazines, even brown paper grocery bags, you know. Because that can add up too. You can save a lot of money that way. So that's our children's portion. Thank you. Okay, so our next group is so many cards here. Mark New and Liz Peterson are going to do folk music for us. So, you're right here. I thought you're both okay. Never. Here's Mark.
This guy's tall. I'm closer to Paul Simon's height. This is going to come up in a minute and sing a couple of songs with me. I'm going to do a James Taylor song to start off with. There's something in the way she moves. It looks my way or calls my name. It seems to leave this troubled world behind. And if I'm feeling down and blue, or troubled by some foolish game, she always seems to make me change my mind. And I feel fine anytime she's around me now. She's around me now, almost all the time. And if I'm well, you can tell. She's been with me now. She's been with me now quite a long, long time, and I feel fine. Every now and then, the things I mean, oh, they lose their meaning, and I find myself dreaming in the places where I should not let me go. She has the power to go, and no one else can find me. I send a sign to remind me of the happiness in good times that I know. Well, I said I just got to know them. Isn't what she's got to say, or how she thinks, or where she's been. To me, the words are nice, the way they sound. I like to hear them best that way. It doesn't much matter what they mean. She says it mostly just to calm me down. And I feel fine anytime she's around me now. She's around me now almost all the time. And if I'm well, you can tell. She's been with me now. She's been with me now quite a long, long time. Yes, and I feel fine.
Thank you very much. I think that's got to go up a little bit. So. I'm just going to turn that little knobby thing. The first song we're going to do together is a song by a little-known songwriter that lives over in Farwell.
It's not a good thing to have this body.
Richard has referred to our set as the granola set. Name of the song is Dusty Road.
Walking the dusty road, tired feet and a heavy load, you're not sure of your destination. You don't even know what road you're taking. No, oh no, 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 no. The night falls and you're on your own, and you know you must get back home. But your reason for life is past you by. Stop and rest your weary head, seeking all of the things you've said. And then you start to see the reason why a man must live and a man must die. Oh my, oh my. Night falls and you're on your own, and you know you must get back home. But your reason for take the breath of the morning air. Look at the road with a dismal stare. Think of all that you want to be. The only thing you can say is me. Night falls and you're on your own. But your reason for life has passed you by. Oh my.
Tell me why.
Yeah. sailing hardships through broken harbors out in the waves of the night. Still the searcher must ride the dark horse racing along in his fright. Tell me why. Tell me why. Is it hard to make arrangements with yourself when you're old enough to repay but young enough to sell? Come and see me, I'll be around for a while. I am lonely, but you can free me all in the way that you smile. Tell me why. Tell me why. Arrangements with yourself when you're old enough to repay but young enough to sell. Sailing hardships through broken harbors out in the waves of the night. Still the searcher must ride the dark horse racing along in his fright. Tell me why. Tell me why. Is it hard to make arrangements with yourself when you're old enough to repay but young enough to sell?
Softer tune, another James Taylor song. A lullaby before Calvinist Anxiety comes out here and rocks the quad. It's a song James Taylor wrote for his daughter, Sarah Maria. And I kind of picture a little child running along a beach when I sing this song. Well, the moon is in the ocean, and the stars are in the skies, and all that I can see is my sweet Maria's eyes. Come on, Sarah, Sarah Maria, Sarah Maria, yeah, yeah, yeah. You know about the sugar cane, it comes from way down south. She's got one end in her hand, she's got one end in her mouth. Come on, Sarah, Sarah Maria, Sarah Maria, yeah, 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 yeah.
I'm walking to the corner of the world. Everyone was talking about such a pretty little girl. Come on, Sarah Maria, Well, the moon is in the ocean, and the stars are in the skies, and all that I can see is my sweet Maria's eyes. Come on,
next group is a rock and roll group. Pretty good. I don't know what you guys feel at rock and roll, but it's always been really special for me. I remember the day that Buddy Holly died, and I was just wiped out by that. I came home from school, I guess I was, what, about 11 and a half, when was that Buddy Holly died in a crash. I really got over it. My enjoyment of rock and roll conflicted with my upbringing, religious upbringing. My stepmother and her boyfriend really had deep roots in the secular humanist tradition, and they were afraid that if I got really messed up by rock and roll and drugs and sex, that I'd really have something to convert away from, and I'd end up maybe Catholic or Baptist or something. They were really concerned about my interest in rock and roll. So now we bring out Calvinist Anxiety, probably known to you from their recent album, Clue. A song on it called The Lounge inspired the Colonel Mustard family and its grisly wrench murders of Mr. Green and his peacock from California. Colonel Mustard's still in jail. He's up for parole, but I don't think they'll ever run out. And so we have Jonathan Dean Lee, Phil Winders, Paul Whitmore, and thanks to re-education, Richard Monberg. And they're going to just either play songs or just goof around on their instruments in a really, you know, arrogant way. Are they ready? Come on.
real concert.
I think they blow it in through the vents actually at the concert.
Why?
Woo! By Jimmy Vaughn and the Fabulous Thunderbirds.
All right.
A song called Tough Enough.
Thank you.
Wave.
To the man who put this all together. It took a lot of work. You know we had to do it sooner or later. Phil Winders. Thank you.
Rawr, in your face.
I went to New York, but my car was tired. Had been hit in the middle by the government that had no pride. From Ohio, I've been replaced by shopping malls.
So tell me, is this your first time here at Hillstock? Is this your first year here? Are you enjoying the show?
Yeah.
You having a good time?
Oh, yeah.
Everybody partying?
Yeah.
All right. Welcome to Hillstock. You enjoying the show? Is this your first time here?
Yeah.
All right. Enjoy.
Hey, hey, hey.
Thank you.
You're live.
Instrumental tune. We kind of jammed together with. Sweet Jane.
First time at Hillstock? Is this your first time here? Enjoying the show? Oh, don't be bashful. Is this your first time at Hillstock?
Yes!
You enjoying the show?
Yes, I am!
Thank you.
Thank you.
But then the camera was shaking.
That's okay, it's only Mills. I don't think the trustees are going to hear this conversation.
How do you do it? Put your hands there!
Good that Phil's an
You're married.
That's true, we're married.
Long time
no, really, really, we are, we're married.
Yeah, right. See,
yeah, there's my band.
That's not a great performance.
No.
Yeah! Yes, I think it was a good performance. Anyone put in more money? Yeah. Housing? How much are you collecting? $1,450? Well, that's pretty good.
Hmm?
Okay.
Can you get me my gloves? They should, yeah. Or they're in my running.
I feel all alone up here somehow. I don't know if anyone's mentioned this to you, but I'm not from the United States myself. I'm a Canadian citizen, the, you know, upper 10 provinces. With some many fascinating similarities and differences between the two countries. For instance, where you guys celebrate your freedom dating from the Boston Tea Party, where, you know, you rebelled against the King of England and everything. Well, in Canada, we date it from the Toronto Beer Party, because it was a huge bash, and the British were so disgusted with us that they declared us independent. So that's how it went. And you celebrate the St. Valentine's Day to commemorate the inroads of organized crime into your society. We do. We have St. Groundhog's Day massacre in Montreal. So that's some of the differences. You're actually pretty lucky here in the United States because you have institutions of higher education, like, for instance, Danover Newton. In Canada, that isn't the case. You have to get your higher education on the streets. And I got my BA, for instance, from the Toronto Rail Yard area. So you really have it pretty good here in the United States. I know that a couple years ago when I was in Canada, I was planning to go to the States to study. I had many questions, and some of them still remain. For instance, Latin Americans, right? Now, I was listening to some of them talk amongst themselves, and I'm pretty sure that they weren't speaking Latin. I think it was like either Spanish or French, I'm not sure. But they're called Latin American, so I still don't understand about them. And our next performer is Jeffrey Dana Hicks. Is he there? So that's what I was sensing at the beginning. That he isn't here. What's that? He'll be here anytime. So move on to the next performer, would you say? Or maybe take a little intermission for people to go and get some natural looking taste treats from the machines in the
next
tournament.
Performer!
You want me to sing? I could do Newton Skyline for you, but I don't have any copy yet. But it goes, it's kind of Newton Skyline, how can something that looks so beautiful be so bad? Newton Skyline, 10,000 teardrops can't be wrong. A 10-minute intermission, so just please go in small groups so that you don't, like, wreck the campus, just, you know, so many. 10 minutes, right back here.